Hello everyone, this is Akshay and in this video we'll be covering event bubbling and capturing in JavaScript. I have faced this question a lot of time in interviews and I used to be very confused about the difference between both of them. Event bubbling, capturing and trickling and delegation and a lot of things. So I was always confused about what these terms relate to and what they are and how they are useful. So in this video I'll be covering all these topics thoroughly with a lot of examples so that it can give you a clear idea about what bubbling, capturing, trickling, delegation are. So first I'll be using a whiteboard to explain you the concepts and then directly we'll jump into the code where I will show you how these things work in the browser. So without wasting any time, let's start with it. So event bubbling and capturing are two ways of event propagation in the DOM tree. So what happens is, so suppose we have nested HTML elements. So let's take an example. Suppose we have a div with an ID parent and we have a child div with ID child. So what happens is, if any event occurs on a child, will propagate to its parent as well. So let's take an example and let me tell you. So suppose if this child has an onClick method of onClickChild. So when you click this child, then the onClickChild method is called. And suppose if you click a parent, onClickParent method is called. So to better understand, let's take this hierarchy to one more level. So let us say that suppose we have one more div, let's consider this as our grandparent with the ID grandparent and it also has an onClick method, onClick grandparent or something, so which is called when you click on this grandparent. So the main thing is the propagation of the events. So suppose if you are clicking this child, then in what sequence these methods will be called? So firstly, let's talk about event bubbling. So in case of event bubbling, so if you click on this child method, so the onClickChild method will be called first, then it moves up to the hierarchy and it goes directly till the end of the DOM. So what happens is the onClickChild method will be called, after that onClickParent method will be called and then the grandparent method will be called. So that is what bubbling it. So to clearly understand it, you can remember it like that, that bubble always comes out. So it is like bubbling out. So the event is bubbling out the DOM tree. So that is how you can relate to it. And then opposite to this is event capturing. So event capturing is the upwards down. So it is capturing down the DOM tree. So what happens is all these three event handlers will be triggered, but the order will be completely opposite to what was there in event bubbling. So when you click on this child, so the grandparent click handler will be called first, then the parent and then the child. So that is how it is. Again, so this was when I clicked on the child div, but what if I clicked on the parent div? So in case of clicking on the parent div and in case of bubbling, this click will be propagated up the DOM. So what will happen is onClickParent will be called and then onClickGrandparent will be called. So that will be the sequence. And in case of capturing, the opposite, onClickGrandparent and onClickParent. So that is what event bubbling and capturing is. Event capturing is also known as event trickling. Event trickling is nothing a separate concept altogether, but it is just another name for event capturing. So some people just use it because it is easier for them to remember that trickle down and then bubble up. So it is like they remember it like trickling down and bubbling up. So it becomes easier for them. So trickling down, that means grandparent, parent and child, and bubbling up, that means on click child, then parent, then grandparent. So this is whole cycle is followed. So back in old days, Netscape advocated to use capturing as the main fundamental while event propagation. While Microsoft was completely opposite. Microsoft said that event bubbling makes more sense. Like if you're clicking on a child, then event should bubble up rather than coming down. So between these arguments, so W3C has now made this a very standard. Event capturing and bubbling both are accepted, and it is now on the developer how they use it. So W3C has made it very much comfortable and developer friendly, and they give us option to use whatever we want to in whatever use case we want to, and we can decide it. So when I say it is up to developers to use bubbling or capturing, let's see how we can do that. So when we are writing click handlers, so in the add event handler method, in the add event handler method, we can pass the third argument as a boolean use capture flag. So let me show you how to do that. So the first argument over here in add click handler is always the event. So for example, a click or any other event. The first is click, then the second is obviously the callback method, which you write, which is called when this event happens. And the third is the use capture boolean argument. So when you are writing these add event handler onto any element, what happens is you pass the event and then the callback and the use capture. This is generally passed as a true or false value. And on the basis of true and false, the browser decides what to do, either to do a bubble or a capture. So when this flag is true, that means use capture is true. So what happens is event capturing mode is enabled and the events are captured. That means the event trickles down or captures down the DOM hierarchy. In other case, if you don't pass any attribute or you pass a falsy value over here, what happens is the events will bubble up or they will go up the hierarchy of the DOM. So that is how you can configure your code to use either event bubbling or capturing in whatever way you want to. So one important thing to note over here is, like in W3C model, the cycle will anyways continue. So what will happen is if you have these click handlers and if a click event is encountered, what will happen? That cycle will continue. The events will trickle down and then bubble up. But by these flags, you can control on whether to capture these events or to bubble out these events. So now I will be giving you a demo of all these things what I have covered inside the editor and the browser, and I will show you how to write the code of all of them and how these things are working. What will happen if you turn off a true or a false flag in a parent or a grandparent or a child, and then in what sequence these methods will be called, how this cycle is followed. I will be covering it thoroughly so that you don't have to look at this explanation again, and then so that it gets to your head very clearly and you will get a better understanding of how these bubbling, capturing, trickling and all these things work. So it is also a base for another concept known as event delegation, which I will be covering later. So just stay tuned and then watch the demo and you will get to know it better.
So that was all the theoretical explanation. Now we'll see it in the browser and how we write the code for bubbling and capturing, how events are propagating up and down the hierarchy of DOM. Let's see all that in action. So I'm starting directly from scratch. So I have created this basic HTML head and body section. That's it. And so I'll be starting directly from scratch. So I'll make the same layout which I was covering on the whiteboard. So that was something like creating a div which has an ID of grandparent, which has a child div, which has a ID of parent, and again a child div, which has ID of child. So this is what our layout was, right? So we had a grandparent, inside that a parent, and inside that a child. So to see this on the browser, let's give it some CSS style also. So style, and let's give the div as min width of 100 px and min height of 100 px again. And then, so what else? Yeah, so let's give it a padding of, let's say 30 px. And then let's give it a border to distinguish all of them of 1 px solid black. Okay, so we have this CSS. Let's see how it looks in our browser. So yeah, so we have this three divs. Above one is the grandparent, and then the next one is the parent, and the innermost one is the child. So that's how our hierarchy is. Now let's add the event handlers onto each of these divs, and let's see how event propagates down the hierarchy. To add event handlers, let's go into the JS file which we have injected into our HTML over here. So in this JS file, I will be using the query selector to get my grandparent parent element, and then I will attach a event listener. I told you, so the first argument will be the event click and then the callback function. So for now, let's just console log something and see grand parent clicked. Okay, so something like this. So let's save it and see in the browser if it is working or not. See, if I clicked on grandparent, so it is working. And even if I click on the children, grandparent clicked is being called, right? So if even I'm clicking on this child. So let's refresh the page, and then let's try to attach event handlers on the other divs as well. So suppose I added it on parent, and then it says parent clicked, and then I attach it to the child also, which says child clicked. So we have these three event handlers attached to all the three divs which we have in our HTML. So let's see how these works. So let me refresh the page and then see the order of execution when I am clicking on this child div. So I clicked on this child div and see the order of execution. So the child clicked is console logged first, then parent clicked, and then grandparent clicked. So that means our events are propagating up the hierarchy. That means the events are bubbling out. So can you relate it, what I told you while I was explaining it on the whiteboard, that the event bubbling is used by default if you don't pass any third argument inside the event listener function. So over here in this event add event listener function, if you don't pass the third argument, then it is considered to be as false by default. So this is exactly the same behavior what we could have observed if we had put all false over here. So let's put all false and check, refresh the page and check it again. So if I clicked on this child, so it is behaving the same. So when you put false over here, it behaves in the bubbling mode. So the events will be bubbled out. So what if I have clicked on the parent and not the child? So see, when I click on the parent is clicked and the event is then bubbled out to the grandparent. If I click on just grandparent, let's see what happens. If I clicked on grandparent, then what happens is only the grandparent callback method is called and grandparent clicked is printed. So that is how the event bubbles up. Now that was event bubbling. Now we'll see what happens in case of event capturing. So if we had all two true flags, as So these are the use capture flags. So if we have all trues over here, let's see what happens. So let me refresh the browser, and if I click on grandparent first, so again it is the same behavior as it was. So but what if I clicked on the child now? So when I click on the child, see, the events are executed. So the events are propagated in a different manner now. So now the grandparent clicked is printed first, then parent clicked, then child clicks. That means when I am clicking on this child, the grandparent callback method is called first, then the parent, then the child. So this is going down the hierarchy. That means it is event capturing, or what we call it as event trickling also. So it is trickling down the hierarchy. So that is what event capturing is. So we saw this in the action. So just guess what we will get the output if we click on this parent and not the child. So if we click on this parent, so see, we have got grandparent clicked and parent clicked. Now think about it, how. So what happened is, while trickling down, it trickles directly from the top, and then it saw a event handler attached to this grandparent, and then it evoked it, and then it evoked the parent click handler. So that's how the event was propagated down the chain. So that means the event was trickled down the hierarchy. So that's how it is. If I click on the child, it prints grandparent, parent, then child. If I click on the parent, then grandparent and parent. And if I clicked on the grandparent, just the grandparent. So that is what event capturing is, or we can call it as event trickling, which trickles down the DOM hierarchy. So this was all about it. But as I said that this has a performance issue, let's see how we can resolve that, how we can stop the propagation at some point of time so that it doesn't cost us a lot, because this operation is very expensive. So as I told you, according to W3C model, so whole chain is anyways followed. The trickling down happens, then the bubbling up happens, whether you do anything. But according to these parameters, that can be adjusted. So let's see, what if I have used a mix and match of these true and false. So if I write false over here, guess what the output will be. So let's refresh the page and see what the output will be. If I clicked on the innermost child, so it printed something else, right? Now in this case, it behaved a little different. So the grandparent clicked is printed first, then the child, then the parent. Now let's see why this happened and how this happened. So as I told you, according to W3C, first the event propagation happens top down the hierarchy. That means first of all capturing happens, then bubbling out happens, and the callback methods are called according to these parameters what we pass as true and false. So what happened is, in this case, while we were attaching our callback method in the grandparent, we said that use capture. So that means the use capture flag was true. So we are using capturing over here. Event capturing over here. We are using bubbling over here, and we are following the mode of capturing again over here. So that means when the event was coming capturing down, so because of this true flag, this click handler was called first. That means grandparent click was printed. Then it went to the second layer, which is parent. Now over here, this flag is false. That means it won't cover in the capturing cycle. So because of this false tag, this callback method was not called over here, because it will be called later in the bubbling stage when the events will be bubbling out. So then it moved to the child and it saw a true. So because of this true flag, the capturing happened and the callback method was called. That means child click was printed. And then later, when this half cycle of this capturing was completed, Then we moved on to the bubbling cycle, and in that bubbling cycle we saw this flag as false and this parent click was called. So that is how it behaves, and it is upon the developers. We can control whether to use the bubbling cycle or whether to use the capturing cycle, and wherever, however is the use case, we can use according to that. So let's tweak more and see how it behaves. Suppose if what we had done is we had made this also false, that means now we are following bubbling over here as well. So think about it first. What will happen if I click on the child? So if I click on the child, let us first try to think what will happen. So first of all, in the capturing phase, so because we have a true flag as the use capture, so that means it will use capturing, and grandparent clicked will be called first. Then it goes down to parent and then it sees a false. So that means it won't be covered in the capturing phase. It will be skipped. Then it goes back to the child. It again sees a false tag. So it will not be covered in the capturing cycle again. It will be covered in the bubbling cycle now. When the target element is reached, now the events will be bubbled up. Now in the bubbling cycle, firstly child clicked will be printed and then the parent clicked will be printed. So let's see if we get this output. So we are expecting the output of grandparent clicked, then child clicked, and then the parent clicked. So let's refresh this and click over here. See, the grandparent clicked, which happened in capturing cycle, and in bubbling cycle, child clicked and parent clicked was called. So that is how we can control our event propagation of different click handlers. Hope you have understood it. Let's move on to how we can stop this propagation. Or before that, I can show you what if I have clicked on the parent also. So if I have clicked on the parent, see, grandparent clicked is called first because in the capturing phase, and then later bubbling is called and parent click was printed. So that was all. So now let's not waste time and then move on to the stop propagation, how we can stop propagating these events up the hierarchy or down the hierarchy, and how is it useful, because this bubbling and capturing are quite expensive things. So when we are writing this callback method inside our event listener, what happens is we have access to this event object. So this E over here will have access to a special method, which is stop propagation. This stop propagation method will help us stop the propagation of the event. So that means if I have put this stop propagation method over here, so that means this propagation will stop at that point of time. So let's make all these flag as false first, so that we can see what happens in the case of bubbling and get rid of these comments.
It's 15 hours.
So because we have put this stop propagation, so our propagation cycle will stop at this point. So that means let's save this and run in browser. So if I click on the child click callback function is called, parent callback function is called, and then it encounters this e.stopPropagation method. So at this point of time, the code stops and the propagation stops. It doesn't print the grandparent clicked. So that is how you can stop the propagation. Let's see what if we have put this e.stopPropagation in our child itself. So we can keep it in our child itself. So if we had put this in our child and refresh the page, and if I click on the child, see, only child click is called. This is a good way. So if we want the click to only be associated with this child and does not trigger the whole propagation cycle, then we should obviously use e.stopPropagation to stop this propagation. It won't bubble out. The event propagation won't bubble out and all the event handlers won't be called. So that is a good way to do it. So let's see this in action in case of capturing. So if we had all these flags as true, so when we do a true in our use capture flags. So in the capturing cycle, let's see how this works. So if I have this true, that means we are in capturing mode now. So, and if I wrote a stop propagation over here and clicked on child, then think of what will be the output. See, the output is all three. So the output is all three event handlers were called. Why? So why? So if you think it properly, then in the capturing phase, it starts from the top. That means it checks the grandparent, then it goes to parent, and then it goes to child, and then it sees the e.stopPropagation method called. So that means the propagation stops at that point of time. So, but till then, all these three callback methods have already been called. So let's try to put this stop propagation method in our grandparent in this case. If we have put this in our grandparent and refresh the page and click on the child again, see, this time only grandparent clicked was called. Why? Because the propagation cycle starts from the top in case of capturing. So when this flag use capture is true, that means it starts and I click on the div of child, then it starts from the top, it called the grandparent clicked, and then the e.stop propagation is encountered. At this point of time, the propagation stops. That is how you can stop the propagation. And I think, hope you have understood it. That's all in this coding session. We'll see you next time. Thank you.
So guys, that was all for this video. I have covered these event bubbling and capturing topics and hope you have enjoyed it. If you really like the video, then do give this video a thumbs up and then stay tuned to my channel, because I am coming up in my next video with event delegation. So event delegation is again a very important concept of JavaScript, which is based upon bubbling and capturing. So that means if you know bubbling and capturing, then you will understand event delegation better, and you can answer that in interview and you can get that concept very easily. So stay subscribed to my channel and click the bell icon for all the notifications of the upcoming video so that you don't miss any video. I am trying to make these videos very precise and to the point so that you can get the information in a very quick and precise way and you don't waste your time. So that was all. So if you have any suggestions for me, or you want me to cover any specific topic in upcoming videos, or you want me to cover any specific interview question, then do send me a message on LinkedIn or Facebook, or just comment down below on this video. I would be happy to help you. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.